A CPU can come with multiple cores that allow it to run multiple tasks at the same time without much hassle. However, how many cores is too much, and how many cores do you actually need to get the job done? While the answer might be reliant on how you intend to work your PC, in our video today, we're going to talk about the general number of cores you need to keep your PC working flawlessly. So, without further ado, let's begin. As of right now, the number of CPU cores you need heavily depend on what you plan to use your computer for. For example, if you're satisfied with just minimal web browsing and working with basic applications, 2 or 4 cores would be sufficient, but let's be honest, no one does that anymore. If you're looking to dabble in even minor video games or editing tasks, you require a CPU that comes with either a 6-core or 8-core build. But if you had to pick one for a specific task, the choice becomes much more important. Let's break it down. Straight off the bat, for gaming, you need to ask yourself if you really need the power of 2 extra cores when your primary objective with a PC is gaming and nothing else. Most games right now don't really utilize more than 6 cores, unless you're talking about Alan Wake 2, so 8 cores aren't an absolute necessity in terms of gaming, since you won't be needing that extra horsepower. However, the keyword here is almost. Since like the aforementioned Alan Wake 2, there are a bunch of titles that require all 8 cores, such as the dystopian, futuristic Cyberpunk 2077, or Miyazaki's masterpiece, Elden Ring. The GPU you pick will also play a big role in determining your processor, and of course having a larger cache and extra cores on your CPU will provide a better FPS. For most gamers, especially for those looking to craft a value-for-money PC, 6-core CPUs are highly recommended by us. For productivity, if you're crafting a PC to run compute-heavy applications such as Adobe Premiere Pro, Blender, or AutoCAD, you'll need all the cores you can get your hands on. Applications that give you an edge by utilizing multiple cores will of course run a lot faster on CPUs with a high core count. These multi-threaded workloads are actually the main reason behind Intel and AMD coming with processors with 8, 12, or even 16-core consumer-grade CPUs. While a 6-core CPU can and will run such applications without much issue, you'll see a noticeable performance gap in comparison, especially if you're a professional and prefer to save as much time as possible. In general, as the number of CPU cores increases, the clock speed of the individual core sees a steady decrease, meaning you get all the benefits of extra cores for your multi-threaded workloads. But applications that depend on clock speed could have a negative effect. This is why we think in terms of performance, 8-core CPU takes the cake. While multitasking might not be the first unit of measurement you rely on when thinking of getting a new CPU, but it plays a crucial role nonetheless. We've worked with a bunch of 6-core CPUs in the past, and while the speed is nothing to complain about, we noticed how they could not keep up with everything. For example, when installing a game, we often find our PC to be almost unusable and don't get us started on Chrome tabs. That's when we decided to upgrade to an 8-core CPU so we could enjoy all the benefits that come from having 2 extra cores. The real value of an 8-core CPU is revealed when you're not worried about closing a few apps and background processes. And it's always better to get yourself a slightly more powerful CPU than you need right now, rather than spending more on the future. While it may not feel like a big deal at first, the amount of power your CPU needs is directly related to the amount of heat it produces, and of course the kind of cooling hardware you'll need to keep everything running cool. If you don't have a proper cooler installed, it's normal for a CPU to get thermal throttled and see a decrease in performance to avoid permanent damage. Modern 6-core CPUs has a maximum power draw from around 65 watts to 125 watts, where even budget air coolers can easily handle this level of heat. 8-core CPUs are a different question altogether though, since they can have a TDP as high as 250 watts and generally run hotter than their 6-core counterparts, requiring an aftermarket cooler as a necessity. Due to the heat, we have to give the crown to 6-core CPUs, as they don't require as much maintenance or require aftermarket upgrades to keep them working properly. While the general assumption is that buying an 8-core CPU would better future-proof your build, the belief is inherently flawed considering how rapidly PC hardware tends to evolve. It's not uncommon to see an 8-core chip getting bodied by a new generation 6-core chips in almost every aspect, and that includes productivity. This happens because gen-on-gen architectural and IPC improvements often overshadow the benefits of having two extra cores. For example, if you have an 8-core CPU, it won't be more future-proof than a 6-core counterpart from the same generation. This fragile state makes it a tie between 6-core CPUs and 8-core CPUs. At the end, price is all but the most important factor when comparing 6-core and 8-core CPUs, considering there's only so much you can spend regardless of the performance considerations. As expected, 6-core CPUs are almost always more affordable than 8-core CPUs from the same generation, ending up to be the best pick for value-for-money builds. Modern 6-core processors have a tendency to fall into the $300 to $325 piece range, while 8-core CPUs can fall into the $400 to $450 range, offering a generous 33% premium. For the more expensive 8-core variant, of course, you'll get a boost in overall productivity and multitasking performance, and while they're not as powerful as 12 or 16-core processors, but they provide a much better price-to-performance ratio. In the end, it all boils down to two things: if you have any need for additional cores, and whether the money you invest in the CPU lead to an overall balanced build. For example, if you get yourself a powerful processor but skimp and end up getting a subpar GPU, that'd be a bad investment. 6-core CPUs are incredible for the masses, and there's always room for upgrade. Get yourself a 6-core CPU if you want a solid 1080p build with minimum effort and respectable performance in productivity applications. However, if you feel outgrown with 6-core CPUs, with an 8-core CPU, you'll get a noticeable boost in multi-core workloads, such as video editing and gaming. You can even stream without your PC taking a lot of strain, and can use your PC as a multitasking powerhouse. Both of these processors have different use cases, and it all jots down to your personal preference. Regardless, what kind of CPU are you running, and what's your experience? Do let us know, as we'd love to hear from you. And as for everything else, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon if you want more content like this on your feed.